إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، الحمد لله، all praise are due to Allah. All thanks are for Him Jalla Jalalu. No God deserves to be worshipped but He Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. All good are in His good hands. We seek His forgiveness at all time, and to Him alone do we repent. May His peace and blessings be upon Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and to all of those who follow their rightly guided path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Az-Zumar, Allahu yatawaffa al-anfusa hina mawtiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He takes the souls at the time of their death. وَالَّتِي لَمْ تَمُتْ فِي مَنَامِهَا. And He takes the souls of for those who He has not yet decreed death upon. He takes their souls during their sleep. فَيُمْسِكُ الَّتِي قَضَى عَلَيْهَا الْمَوْتِ. And then He holds on to the souls that He has decreed death upon. وَيُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. And He releases the souls that He has yet to decree death upon, and He releases them back to their bodies for a specified term. إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Indeed, these are signs for people who give thought. أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُوا. Wherever you are in this earth, you could be in the most remote place. Nobody knows of this place apart from yourself. يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتِ. Death will come and find you and it will overcome you. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was advised by Jibra'il alayhi salam, and he said to him, وَأَحْبِبْ مَنْ شِئْتِ. And love whoever you want in this life. Love whoever you want in this life, فَإِنَّكَ مُفَارِقُهُ. Because in the end, you will have to be separated from them. Now the khatib that was supposed to be here today, as I had come in today, I had found out that he had excused himself. Secondly, he has excused himself because what? Because his father had passed away today. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. وَأَحْبِبْ مَنْ شِئْتْ فَإِنَّكَ مُفَارِقُهُ. And love whoever you want in this life, for in the end, you will have to be separated from them. And if I was to ask every single person sitting here today, who is the most beloved person to you in this life? After Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the overwhelming answer would be your mother or your father. For those of us who have both parents alive, for those of us who only have one parent alive, this will be the overwhelming answer. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. And if you were to try and count the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with, you will not be able to count. And from the greatest blessings, for those of us who have both parents alive or one parent alive, this is a very enormous blessing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He brought you forth from the wombs of your mother. لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. You did not know a single thing. Your mother, she fed you. She clothed you. She bathed you. She looked after you. لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. And a person will not be able to live if their mother did not look after them. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ. Give thanks to me and give thanks to your parents. Why? Because they looked after you. If they didn't look after you, probably wouldn't be here today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah, وَاعْبُدُ اللَّهِ. And worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. And do not associate any partners with him. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be good to your parents. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا. After commanding us to worship him alone, what is he going to say? وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be good to your parents. إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. If one of you, you witness one or both of your parents alive, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. Do not even utter the mildest sound of disrespect, which is أُفْ. وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. And do not be horrible towards them. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. And be kind to them. Say gentle words to them. Be polite to them. Respect them. Appreciate them. وَخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ. And be humble towards your parents. Be humble towards them. وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. And make dua for them. Oh Allah, have mercy on them, just like they had mercy on me when I was small. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. In a hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was ascending on the minbar. And he said, Ameen, three times. And the companions, they inquired to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they said, Ya Rasulullah, why did you say Ameen? And one of the reasons he said Ameen, he said, the angel Jibra'il alayhi salam, he came to me and he made dua and he said, may his nose be rubbed in the dust. I.e. may he be humiliated. A person who grows up and he witnesses one of his parents or both of his parents alive and he does not attain paradise. And he said, Ameen. And he said this dua and I said, Ameen to it. In another hadith, see the companions, they were very eager to know how could they attain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love and his pleasure. So Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said in a hadith, he says, سَأَلْتُ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. I asked the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, and I said to him, أَيُّ الْعَمَلُ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ. What is the most beloved action towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And he said, الصَّلَاةُ عَلَى وَقْتِهَا. Then he said, pray in the prayer on its time. Then he said, ثُمَّ أَيْ. See, they were very eager to know what actions could they do to attain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. And they said, what else can we do, Ya Rasulullah? And he said, بِرُّ الْوَالِدَيْنِ. Being good and dutiful to your parents. عمر بن عبد العزيز رضي الله رحمه الله, he gave a beautiful advice. And he said, do not befriend the one who is not kind to his parents. For how can this person be kind to you if he is not kind to his parents? And I leave you with this command that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to us. أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكِ. Give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings He has blessed you with. And also give thanks to your parents for everything they've done for you. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّوْنَا صِغَارًا. رب ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.